Hello students, welcome to CMI's online classes. Today in this class, in this video, we are going to start a new chapter, chapter 3 from our English literature, that is a poem, and the title of the poem is Somebody's Mother and is written by Mary Dobrine. The poem Somebody's Mother by Mary Dobrine is a beautiful poem depicting wonderful values of care and love for others. But before explaining the poem, I would like to ask some questions to you all. How do you behave with your parents and grandparents at home? How do you behave and treat with other elderly people, mostly old people, whenever you see them? When you are out of your home, do you behave well with them? Do you behave well with your parents, grandparents, and other elderly people in your family and in the society? Or you make fun of them? Do you give your extra time to your parents and grandparents at homes? What happens around us, as we have seen, is that whenever a person grows older, he or she is uncared by the family members and other people in the society. They are also humans. They have grown older doesn't mean that they need nothing. They also have daily needs like we all have. We have to care about them and should give our extra time to show our love and affection that we really care about them, and we should ask them what they need. This makes them happy and cheerful, and it brings sunshine in their daily boring life. It is a cycle of human life. Whatever we do is followed by our next generation. If we treat and behave well with others, our parents and grandparents, our next generation, our sons and daughters, to behave well with us when we also grow older. The numbers of old age homes are increasing every year in huge numbers. It means that these old aged people are becoming homeless and left by their children. Though an old age home also cares about these old people, but it cannot give a person real happiness one feels with his or her family members. This should be stopped. We should care about our parents, grandparents, and every other person around us whenever we see them in need of help. This changes a human being to the real sense of being human. So this is all what we are going to understand and learn from the poem Somebody's Mother. At first, we will read the poem and then we will understand the poem with the explanation and the summary of the poem. So this is how the poem is written. Somebody's Mother by Mary Dobrine. The woman was old and ragged and grey, and bent with the chill of a winter's day. The streets were white with a recent snow, and the woman's feet were aged and slow. She stood at the crossing and waited long, alone, uncared for, amid the throng of human beings who passed her by, nor heeded the glance of her anxious eye. Down the street with laughter and shout, glad in the freedom of school let out, came the boys like a flock of sheep, hailing the snow piled white and deep. Past the woman so old and grey, hastened the children on their way. Nor offered a helping hand to her, so meek, so timid, afraid to stir, lest the carriage wheels or the horse's feet should crowd her down in the slippery street. At last came out of the merry troop the gayest laddie, of all the group. He paused beside her and whispered low, "I'll help you across if you wish to go." Her aged hand on his strong young arm, she placed, and so, without hurt or harm, he guided her trembling feet along, proud that his own were firm and strong. Then back again to his friends he went, his young heart happy and well content. She's somebody's mother, boys, you know, for all she's aged and poor and slow, and I hope some fellow will lend a hand to help my mother, you understand. If ever she's poor and old and grey, when her own dear boy is far away. And somebody's mother bowed low her head in her home that night, and the prayer she said was, "God be kind to the noble boy who is somebody's son and pride and joy." So this is how the poet has written very beautifully in his poem. And this beautiful poem, Somebody's Mother, inculcates in us this very real value of human beings, the real definition of human being and living in this planet being humans. The poem begins by saying that an old woman wearing poor turned out clothes was standing at a crossing to go to the other side of the road. She was waiting for the traffic to stop so that she could safely go to the other side. She kept waiting, but the traffic did not stop. No passersby paid heed to her need and concern. After some time, a group of boys came out of the school. They were happy and noisy, playing with the newly fallen snow. They moved past the old woman standing at the crossing, but no boy offered to help her go across the road. However, one boy noticed her and went to help her. He lovingly helped her cross the road. As he went back to his friends, he said he helped the old lady, thinking someday someone would help his old mother in a similar situation when he might be far away from her. The boy felt very happy and satisfied after helping the old woman. The old woman that night prayed to God to be kind to the boy who had helped her cross the road. And this was the summary of the poem. I hope you have understood the poem. Finally, I want to add some points with the explanation of the poem, that we want everyone to be kind upon us, but in many situations we become unkind to others, especially when it comes to our behavior with old and elderly people at our homes and in the society. So if we want everyone to be kind upon us, we too have to be kind upon everyone. If we help the people around us, they bless us, and their blessings bring real happiness in our lives. So the little boy in the poem perfectly display the character how a student like you all should be. You all should be kind-hearted, caring and loving towards the people around you and help them when they are in need. So the poem tells us about the old lady who was somebody's mother, who was very poor from his physical strength. He was trembling of fear of the slippery street and the crowd of people, and was unable to cross the road. He was surrounded by the people, but no one cared about her and no one asked her what she wanted to do. At the same time, the group of students come after their school was over and one who was the happiest in the group offered his help to the old woman and helped her cross the road. He then went to his friends and told them that he was very happy to help that old woman, as he thought that someday when his mother will also grow older and when he might be away from his mother and when his mother would be in the similar condition of the present old woman, someone will be there to help his mother. So helping someone is like a ripple on the surface of water. It comes back to you sometime, someday. So we should be helpful, kind and caring about everyone around us, and we should help everyone whenever we see someone in need. So I hope this poem has made you strong enough to be kind and loving to other people around us. Maybe those people are in our family or those people who we do not know also. But if we see them that they are in need of help, we, without any question, we need to help them and assist them to reach what they actually want to get with our help. So I hope you have understood the poem. If you have any doubts, you need to ask me and without any hesitation. This much for today's class. I hope you all have understood. In our next class, we will understand and explain the questions and answers from this chapter.